Now that you're familiar with the basic R commands, let's look at some more data. This time, we'll be looking at data collected from a survey of Reddit users. Reddit's a social and entertainment website where users can post links and comments about trending news. This survey asked users about demographic information, such as gender, age, nationality, and employment status. It even asked users what type of cheese they would be, and whether they preferred dogs, cats, or turtles. Download the dataset from the instructor notes and load it into R. Once you've done that, take a look at the data by using the stir function. Now, when I try to read in the file, sometimes I might get an error. This is pretty common, so I would suggest looking at your current working directory to figure out the problem. Oftentimes, your directory isn't where your file is stored. All right, so I've set my directory, and now I'm going to try this code up here again. And there we go. There's our data. Running the stir command, we can see that there's lots of data here. Most of these variables have a type of factor. Now, a factor is a categorical variable that has different flavors or levels to it. An example of this would be employment status. This variable has many different levels, such as employed full-time, or employed part-time, or not working. One thing we might be interested in is how many people are in each group of employment status. We can table that variable to see the number in each of these groups. Running this code, I can see the table. We can also get these counts and other data points by running the summary function on our data frame. I encourage you to check out the output of this for yourself. In addition to factor variables like employment status, the R programming language also has other data types like lists and matrices, but we really won't be working with them in this course. We've included a reference for data types in the instructor notes, so if you'd like to learn more about those, check it out.